But then you have any ideas?
I
have
any ideas.
Cool, so I'll start. I'm Darsh. Today I'm going to talk about how to score sensitive information from CI/CD process.
So I'll begin with who am I.
So I'm head of DevOps at Time Analytics. It's a fintech startup basically. It's Chennai based and I'm CEH. I got my CEH when I was 16. That's quite young, I know. And I'm currently doing CAC at VIT Vellore.
So,
what is CI/CD? How many of you are aware about CI/CD?
Cool, two of you.
Can you like give a brief?
CI/CD is a continuous integration and continuous delivery that is helpful in deploying the software automatically.
Yes, all right.
We can also integrate some test automation in the pipeline.
So, how many of you are using GitHub? Everyone, I guess? Right. So let's say you have a React project. You want to deploy it to XYZ, let's say Heroku. You want to deploy it to Heroku, okay. So what you do is, what you usually do is, you keep pushing on your GitHub repo. When you want to deploy, you clone it and use it, then push it on Heroku, right? That's what you do. Or on XYZ server, you can dockerize it and use it. But what CI/CD process does is, you directly push your code on GitHub. It has a link. GitHub has these hooks basically, GitHub hooks. So it directly sees, okay, there is a new commit. It will build that commit. It will also test those commits using unit tests or whatever integration tests you have written. And it will also deploy. So that is the whole CI/CD process. There's a slide here. Okay. So this is basically a typical process. It's a bit technical, but it will get you the context. That's why I'm explaining you guys this. So you write the code, you push it to GitHub. Version control repo is basically GitHub, SVN, anything you use. Then the unit test, integration test. Unit tests are basically these components are working or not. Let's say, does this render, does this not render, does this component, whatever, XYZ. After that you build it. You need to minify the JS if you're using React and stuff. You build that. And then you put, this is image repo thing is if you're using Docker containers or not, you push it to the Docker registry basically. And then you deploy to whatever server you want. Now this whole process is used by 90% of the tech companies, major tech companies, and it's open source. So if you might have seen the VS Code repo, all of you might be using VS Code, right? So if you have seen VS Code repo, there might be a build tag called build parsing or something, build fading, whatever. What is that? It shows that there is a CI/CD process and the build is passing. So now we can use that to get some sensitive information out of that. How? So these are the major CI services, CI/CD services. Travis and CircleCI are basically free for open source projects. Jenkins is a self-hosted service, so like if you own a server, you host it on yourself and it'll take your server. This can be hosted locally, so there's no scope usually. So this thing which I'm talking to you about is not like cutting edge technology or something. This was one of the Travis's messages. In 2015, I guess. So what happened was, there was a talk at Black Hat USA about the same CI/CD process. So what happened was, a lot of people got aware of that. So everybody started scanning those services. So what they were literally under attack because of scanning it. So what they did was, they started, usually, the environment, how many of you know about environment variables? Cool, nice. So for those of you who don't know, you just export the environment variable system which any program can read it. It's system specific, you need to export it once, or you can like in bash RC or something, that's fine. So usually while building a project and stuff, you usually put your API keys and all in an environment variable, and then that environment variable is used in other processes, whatever. So earlier, Travis and all, they were not hiding these. It was public, so anybody can see those keys. So usually what people did was they just do source or whatever, so it was not printed out in logs. But sometimes it might have been printed out in logs. So what happened was, when you scan these logs, you get those keys, right? Sometimes you get GitHub API keys, you can push to that guy's repo and all. So that's an interesting thing, but that has been fixed since years. This was 2015. But what happened was, sometime, let's say I am building my project, I want to debug it. What I do is, I just to print whatever key. So to debug it, a lot of people do that, right? Sometimes they forget about it. So what I did was, I'll just open a repo and show you, so you guys can. So let's say this is a React project. I have a build tag. So what this is, I'll be talking about Travis a lot. So like, get familiarized with Travis. So after it loads, Travis is a build service. So it shows that the master repo, the latest build was, I don't know, 2 days ago, and it has built. Now they have these logs. These are the build logs of my repo. Okay. So it's a React project. So it just minifies the JavaScript and deploys it on Google. GitHub pages, I guess. So these logs, they are censored. All the API keys are hidden, usually. But let's say I printed it for debugging, whatever XYZ reason, right? So now finding this, you won't be going to be open each and every page, right? They are like, this is the latest build. There'll be like 20, 30 other builds in the build history thing. Where's build history? Yeah, build history. So now in one of these logs, there might be the hidden API key or whatever, right? So how do you find that? So what I did was, I made this Python I won't call it a project, it's not so big actually, it's a small module. I built this Python module. What it does is, you just give it the URL for the GitHub repo. It will find all the repositories in that. It will also find all the people connected to the organization. You are aware that GitHub has organizations, right? So let's say Forsation. So GitHub Forsation has like 200-300 repos, and that also has like 200-300 people associated to it, right? And usually what people do is, let's say I'm working on XYZ project, I'll fork that repo to my GitHub, right? So there might be that in my GitHub fork, when I'm building, I might have something in my logs, right? So what this tool does is, BuildScour, I'll change to the presentation back again. Yeah. So what this tool BuildScour does is, it will see the organization, it will fetch all the repositories of that organization, it will also fetch all the people associated with that organization, and start searching through their build logs. It will first find Travis build logs, it will then find CircleCI build logs, and it will store all of them so that we can grab them and find all the APIs, if they are any. Usually they are censored. So it basically is the same process I explained. It first enumerates all the repositories available in that project, XYZ project. It scours them on all the CI services. Basically, there are only two major services, that's CircleCI and TravisCI. After that, it saves all the build logs in your local computer. So next, so what did I find? Okay, this is interesting. Why? Because this should have been fixed in 2015. It has still not been fixed. Like, it's human error. It cannot be fixed. So a couple of GitHub tokens, nobody gave me any bounty for that, for some reason. After that, DB creds, I don't know. Some people love using DB underscore pass and DB underscore username and just print it out. I don't know why. That was one instance, and the best thing was, I found a RSA key, private key. I didn't attempt anything. I don't know. I had a couple of errors. I kind of have tried SSHing and all.
So after that, code execution.
So yes, let's say in the build logs, you find that the PyY package is not installed. Usually what people do to install Python packages, pip install whatever, right? Or they say npm package, npm install whatever. Or Ruby, whatever you use in Ruby. Now these services, anybody can upload a package, right? This BuildScour, I uploaded it on PyY. So any of you can pip install BuildScour and it will install it on your system. So let's say a package was not found. Whatever repository code you have, the code on your repository, it's using a package XYZ. It's still working without that, the packet not found, error is there, okay, fine. So what do we do about it? What I will do as a malicious attacker is, I just register that packet, I'll have my own code, it's my packet, whatever I upload, nobody checks that. So whenever in the build process, it downloads my package and uses it in the code, I get code execution, right? So that's that and the demo. So
you guys can you guys read the text or should I zoom in some zoom? Is the font size, yeah. Cool. Cool, so there is basically two ways that you can use this. You can either do pip install BuildScour, or you can just directly clone the local repo and get the Python file. I already have the development version of it, so I'll likely use this. So let's find a target organization. Let's say RocketJack. So this is a GitHub org. It has 143 some repositories in it. It also has 23 people associated in that repository, right? So what this tool does is, it will first see all the repositories available. It will then also see all the people available and their repositories. It uses the GitHub API V3. There's also V4 API, which is GraphQL. How many of you know about GraphQL? Nice. Cool stuff, right? So, let's find something interesting on RocketJack's repository. So, what we'll do is, let's first see the man page of this, so it helps. So this is basically, I'm just telling that the org is RocketJack and we are storing it in build logs folder. Okay, so yeah, there's no GitHub token. It needs a GitHub token to traverse through all the repositories and all the people of it. Okay, so as I said, I'm using the GitHub API. So I'll just, see, I'm also saving it in the file. The file already has export whatever my API key is, so that I don't have to show it on the screen. So it will take a couple of minutes for a software key logs to generate, so we'll just wait for it. So right now what it's doing is, it will find all the people they are engaging. Yeah, so it found 30 repositories, then it's checking, okay, so Travis CI, where's Travis CI? Okay, fine, there are 25 builds for rocket.chat repository on Travis CI. So after that, it will download all the logs for that. Now it's, yeah, cool, it has downloaded 25 logs, I guess, so I'll just stop it. This can go on for hours if you want all the logs and stuff. So I'll go to the build logs folder.
So it has like a, this was like yesterday or something. So we have a few logs, right? What we'll do is, I already have pushed a couple of word lists for that. These are not those cracking, password cracking word lists. These are basically most common environment variables for tokens, passwords, API keys, whatever.
I'll show you one of those, so yeah.
So this word list is basically what FTP underscore user. These are basically the common environment variables which people like to use. How did we I gather them? It was not me who gathered these. I found a very nice Medium article. What this guy did was in the second or third study, you guys saw the secure thing, right? That it hit the API keys and all, right? The fix for the attack thing. So what that guy did was he scraped Travis for all the secure, the word secure, because Travis is already censoring the API keys and all, right? So he scored everything on Travis. He made a list out of it that okay, these are the most used environment variables.
So like I filtered these to a small list and a large list. Large list takes a while, so I will just use the small one. Cool, so now there are like four folders, there are four repositories. It has been already sorted by repository. So if I like, let's say I'll see the Electron repository. So it will have like Travis and the build number. It has all the text files for all the build logs. I'll show you one of the build logs so you guys like know about the process. I'll open it on VS Code somewhere. So this is basically a build log. It shows each and every step performed by the build service. So it's like it's using Gradle. It's an Android thing, I guess. So it's like it clones the repo, it builds it, it downloads all the tools, whatever, XYZ, right? This is not interesting for us. But what is interesting is there might be, let's say, a package is not found. So you can register a packet in your name, you can get code execution. If let's say some XYZ developer, he wishes to, let's say, he just presses echo or whatever, you get a token, right? So what I'll do is I'll simply use grep. It will recursively find all the XYZ words in the keyword list and all the build logs. Simple as that, right?
So I'll talk a little bit about, I love this tool, grep. Okay, so grep is R is recursive, L is show line number, and I is basically ignore case, I guess. And F is we are just telling it that okay, this is the file, you need to find all the keywords from.
I've already used this, so it's already showing me in the suggestions. I am not in the right. Let's say cool.
So as you can see, Rocket Chat has a very good build process. No pool actually echoed something or whatever, actually. So what you can see right now is, like I talked about, Travis usually censors these things. So it shows, okay, somebody exported GitHub token, it has already been censored, XYZ, whatever, right? So this is it. Why I am telling you this? Because see, these build logs, they are very boring stuff. You find the org, you go to the GitHub repo, you see the code, whatever, right? After that, there is this one vector that you can try. Okay, I won't guarantee that okay, you will find something interesting. It is one vector you can try, you might find something interesting. Let's say you find a GitHub token with push access to all the repositories. Somebody gave a P1 for this. Okay, how many of you are on bug bounty platforms? Two of you? Nice. Okay, cool. So that is it. Questions? Yes?
Can you again go to the code execution question part? That after getting a token, anyone can just push to the pin code?
No, that's not what I was talking about, code execution. Code execution as in, let's say your package, you are using, let's say, you found a new way to, there's a package which Freddy prints things, so it prints everything in pretty colors, that's all. Okay, Python package, let's say, color my code, what color my log, whatever, let's name it color my log. So what color my log does is, it prints your logs in good colors, like red, green, blue, whatever, okay. So now, what I did was, while in the requirements.txt, where I was doing, everybody knows Python, right? So requirements.txt, I made a spelling error. I didn't like color my log, I like color my logs. Yes, okay. So that package has not been found, right? So that package was not found. So what I do is, I'll upload a package, color my logs on PyPy. And in the whatever, let's say in import, usually people import that. So in the, when it's imported, I'll execute some exquisite code. And then I can upload that. That's the kind of code execution I was talking about. Anybody else? Cool.